Good morning, YouTube. It is Saturday morning, about 6:30. We've been out here all night trying to catch a big shark. You see, the grass is giving us heck, and we just haven't been able to do it. We've caught a lot of fish, and we have lost a lot of fish, but we've caught a lot of redfish lately, and I've got a bunch of pictures on the internet of people wanting to know how we do it, and I'm just going to try to make a little quick how-to video on how to catch a redfish from the surf, a big redfish, 40-plus incher. Well, it all starts first with the water. 90% of the fish are in 10% of the water. We are in Port Arthur, Texas, the Texas coast. It's Sea Rim State Park. You can look it up on the map and you can go exactly to where we're fishing right now. That's the main part, where the fish are. It's September right now, redfish season, but you can catch them all through July, some in June, July, September, and right up to October. And big ones too. I'll post pictures at the end of the video. What gear we use to do this, I'm going to go over gear, bait, rods, I guess that's part of gear, but we're going to go over all of that. First off, we have the leaders. We shark fish, so these are little beefed up leaders. We got a 5-foot leader right here with a 16-aught circle hook. 2 foot of steel cable, 3 foot of 400 pound monofilament with a fish finder slider. We usually use a 2 ounce spider weight or a 4 ounce. This is a 2 ounce spider weight. Second rig, when we're trying to catch a big shark or a redfish, we use a 10 foot leader. It's so one little bit bigger size hook. I think that's a 15 aught size circle hook. Same with the Coast Lock fish finder rig. The guy I buy these leaders from is bloodlinetackle.net on the internet. You can look him up, Aaron Johnson. He makes pretty dang good leaders. Well, at least we think so. hook size, anything. I mean, these are 18-aught circle hooks for sharks or attempt to catch sharks, and we actually caught a pretty good redfish on an 18-aught circle hook tonight on a shark bait. We couldn't keep the redfish beat off of us. So I'm about to show you what we usually use for redfish bait, and then we usually use for rod setup and bait deployment and all that. And then I'm gonna show you a redfish and a bunch of pictures at the end of this video, so hang tight. All right, we're gonna talk a little bit about rod and reels. This is what I'm using. It is a Pin Conflict 8000 on a Pin Prevail 11-foot surf rod with 50-pound braid. I think the 8000 holds around 475 yards. Distance on getting the bait out into the surf, you can see he's gonna walk out there right now, probably maybe get to the third sandbar, probably just cast off the second. They're really biting right now. You don't need to go very much farther. How far to go? The answer really is you can't go too far. We've put baits out 300, 400 yards, caught big fish. At the same time, have bait out 150 yards and caught a big fish. But you can go too close. If you're not getting bites close, you need to go further, especially out in this Texas coast surf. On the bigger reel we use for redfish, it's a little overpowered. It's a Pin Squall 30 wide. It'll hold 800 yards, a 40-pound test, something around like that's what we have on it. But we can kayak it out there a long ways and still get bit. You see, he's going to walk out there probably to the third sandbar today, maybe the second, I don't know, whatever he feels like. We've been catching them all over. Cast it out, walk it back in, put it in the PVC stake, sit under the canopy and wait for him to bite it. And I'll come back to you when we have a fish in probably just a couple of minutes, maybe. All right, we're gonna show you what kind of bait we got. Mainly mullet. Got a king mackerel there for sharks. He ain't doing no good for us today. You can see, well, these are all mullet we've caught in the surf. Show you how we prepare it. That size there is about right. You can get actually a little on the big side, but that's fine. A big redfish will suck that right up. How we're gonna cut him is from here and here. Just use that gut pocket. Cut that off. Cut that off. That's how we're gonna use our mullet. Gut pocket of the fish. I'll show you how we hook it on the hook and take it out. All right, I don't know the exact anatomy of a mullet. This is the front, this is the back. What we're gonna do is start a hole right there, push it outwards, got that. Try to keep all the guts inside, the fish like the guts. And then we're gonna hook him right through there to keep all the guts in with the hook. Now you have that rig just like that, and it is ready to go kayaked out or cast it out. We'll come back and show you how we do that in just a second. Yep. All right, we caught one almost just as fast as we got back to the bank. I don't think he's no monster. Come on down here and see what it's like. Not a monster, but he's a redfish. I'll try to show you a big one before the video's ended.
Kind to be taking my time in a place that's worth a damn. And today's another day.